No, you know, sometimes we commit sins that we don't even know we get into. Hallelujah. Because the Bible says, my people perish because of the lack of knowledge.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You're going to have to take the time to know the word. You're going to have to take the time to get here and be encouraged and be built up in your most holy faith.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
You're going to have to take time in prayer, talking to God. Hallelujah. Telling him how you really feel. Telling him what you really want. Telling him, hallelujah, that, Lord, I realize that by myself I can't do this. Hallelujah. I need you. Hallelujah. To get me through this. Hallelujah. You got to take the time. He says, ask me. Ask and it shall be given unto you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Seek me and you're going to find me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He says that if you take my yoke upon you, I'll give you rest.
Yes.
You know, rest is cessation from the things that trouble or bother you. Hallelujah. You don't have to be careful for nothing when you enter into his rest. But it's not an easy thing. You got to take the time to do it. R is to rehearse and remember. You've taken the time to hear the word, and you've come to Bible study to study the word. And maybe you're new, and maybe you're like me. I shared this experience. When I first got saved, I was intimidated by the fact that when my husband got saved, he seemed to get an instant understanding of the word. That he could read the word for hours and get revelation and all of that. And I wondered, you know, what's wrong with me, Lord? But I had sense enough to be quiet so y'all wouldn't know I didn't know nothing. Hallelujah. And I also had sense enough to be here and to hear the word. And anybody who has ever said in any service at Northside Christian Center, no, we get the word. Hallelujah. Our pastors work hard to make sure that we get the word. Even when we don't have sense enough to eat it ourselves.
That's right.
They feed the word to us.
Right.
Hallelujah. So that we can be bold and confident in the Lord. And so we don't have to be tossed aside by every wind and every storm that comes along. The Bible says that you have to ask. When you ask God, when you come to him, you got to ask him in faith. Hallelujah. He says that you can't be wavering. Because if you waver, you're going to be tossed aside to and fro. In the storm, in the sea. And you know, in Sunday school the other day, we learned that the sea wasn't necessarily a good place. But it said, you're going to be like that ship in the sea. We found out that the sea was the holding place sometimes for the spirits of those who died not in truth. And it was a terrible place to be. You don't want to be like that tree, that sea. But the Bible says that if you ask wavering, you just like that sea. Hallelujah. And I'm not gonna go all the way into it. Y'all need to come to Sunday school. You gotta take time. You gotta take time. You know, we don't have near the responsibilities that Pastor and Sister Hill have. But, you know, as assistant pastor, I watch my husband. And you know, he always, you know, he likes to brag.
Amen.
He's always got. How many Sundays have you not heard he don't get sick?
Every Sunday.
Every Sunday. You hear him brag, he don't get sick. And he doesn't. He doesn't because he has the reality of the word working in his life. He knows he gets sick. But as his wife, I know he gets tired, you know, sometimes. I know how hard of a working he is and the things he has to put in to provide for his family. And to minister to others and to take care of his mother and prepare for Sunday school. And I see him when he wakes up at the crack of dawn, before the sun comes up with that Sunday school book, trying to get an understanding and a revelation from the word to share with us so that we can be victorious and overcomers in this life. You want to know how to overcome? You come to Sunday school. You come to the prayer of the study of the Bible on Wednesday night. You want to know how to overcome? You take the time and you do that. And I see that time that he puts in to doing that. And sometimes we would like to get away and rest sometimes. And as a matter of fact, we are next week. Praise God, and I thank God for that. But Sometimes you want to get away, but then he thinks, well, I have this responsibility. You know, I've been called to minister. Who's going to teach Sunday school? And sometimes we do get away and we have asked other people to teach Sunday school, and I'm sure they do an excellent job. But he doesn't take that lightly. Hallelujah. And I know, and our pastor, they go, how many hours does Pastor Hill spend studying and toiling? And how many nights sleep did you guys lose praying and worrying about us? And whether we're going to be all right. And whether we're going to make it through this thing that we're going through. And, you know, the Lord tells you things to tell us to do, you know, so that we can be overcome. And it's got to be disappointing when you get there and it's only a few of us here. We've had mornings in Sunday school that it was only one or two people. Now, we've got some faithful, faithful Sunday school members. And I thank God for the Sister Shirley's and the Brother Travis's and all of Sister Williams, I'm sorry. Praise God. But you know, sometimes Sister Williams and Brother Williams, they got to go out of town and take care of their family. And sometimes Sister Shirley has to go to work. And different people have different things and responsibilities that they have to take care of. And sometimes folks just need to rest and they just got to be gone. And if it happens that week happens all at the same time, everybody's gone, we get to Sunday school and it might be one or two people there. But you know, God is so good that he's placed such a love in the hearts of our pastors and our teachers that even if just one person is there, they feel like it was worth it. Praise God. Because they love us so much that they don't care if everybody else don't get it. If Sister Candy gets it, then my work wasn't in vain. Glory to God. And you know, when you're in the ministry, you kind of like parents. And you know how we like to brag as parents on our kids? You know, when our kids are successful in life, when our kids, you know, nothing touches my heart more than to see my kids grown up and serving the Lord. And as a children's church teacher, you know, I got to see lots of kids come through the ministry, and some of them have great ministries. And some of them, you know, ministries maybe you might not heard of, but they're still serving the Lord. And when I see them, I am so proud of them. You think they were my kids. Praise God. I am so proud of what God is doing in them and for them. Yeah, as I said, some of them are doing great things, and then some of them are doing little baby things that you don't even know that they're doing, but it's making an impact on the kingdom of God. And you feel so proud when that happens. As a matter of fact, I'm just going to wait on that because it's going to bring me back to the S part. We don't want to get to the S too fast. And you're going to be missing up these letters. People won't recognize trust, and you might not know how to trust God. Praise God. Hallelujah. The number two reason why we don't experience the fullness of God's blessing is we forget. We forget how good God is. Yes. We forget what he's done in the lives of others and how he worked in times of old. Hallelujah. How he's worked in our past situations. How he's worked things out for our families and all. The Bible says that we ought to be going over this over and over and over again and rehearse it. He told the children of Israel, hallelujah, to teach this to your kids and to go over and over and over. Don't forget it lest you fall into sin. Hallelujah. Don't forget how good I am. Hallelujah. And to remember means to recall to the mind by an act or effort. Remember I said it wasn't easy. You got to do something. Hallelujah. Of memory. You have to retain in the memory. You got to keep it in mind. You got to remain aware of it. And when I looked in the Bible dictionary, it says that memory was a memorial. Hallelujah. You know, many times when God did great things in the wilderness for children of Israel, he told them to build a memorial. And the purpose of building that memorial is every time you pass by this, you remember what great things I did for you there. So that when you get to that next hard thing, you know that there's nothing too hard for me. And that you don't fall into the sin of doubt and unbelief and fail to enter into the promises and the good things that I have for your life. Hallelujah. You is to unload. The Bible says that we are to cast our burdens in Psalms 55:22 upon him. It says that, but he tells us to cast our burdens upon him because he cares for us. But we have to know now that he cares for us to be able to do that. And to cast means to roll them over, take them off of you totally, and let me carry it. Hallelujah. And we do that unloading in prayer. Hallelujah. And we do that unloading in remembering and confessing the word of God. Hallelujah. The number three reason that we sometimes miss out on the blessings and the fullness of God is because we don't feel worthy. Some people are carrying around a load of guilt that's keeping them from getting to the promise of God. And you know, sometimes the guilt is somewhat justified. Well, it's always justified. Well, no, because sometimes it's a false guilt. Sometimes you think you've done something that you didn't have no part of. Hallelujah, because the devil just tried to do that to you to keep you from accepting what God has for you. And then sometimes we do sin. Sometimes it's an error that we sin. And I'm not looking at nobody, but how many sometimes you have found yourself, especially, you know, because we're a work in progress. And sometimes, if you really think about it, some of the things we did was willful. Hallelujah. And when you mess up or when you stumble, you need to understand that it is absolutely no surprise to God. He knew that you would stumble. Now, I'm not saying that he's going to wink on your sin. You don't have to get it right. But he knows that you are flesh. Hallelujah. That sometimes you're going to stumble. And 1 John 1:9 didn't just get in the word, to become into existence, just when Pastor Hill told us that we could go to it. From the foundation of the world, he had that 1 John 1:9 to be our way of escape. Hallelujah. From the foundation of the world, he knew that man was going to sin. And man in the likeness of Adam was going to sin. And from the foundation of the world, he put a plan in place that his son would come and take on your sin and take on your punishment and take on your sickness and take on your peace. Hallelujah. So that you don't have to take them on. And to make it possible for him to forgive you and so he could look at you again. Because God couldn't look at us in our sinful states. Hallelujah. But from the foundation of the world, he knew that and he put that plan in place. And 1 John 1:9, let's just turn to that. Hallelujah. When God was giving me this, I kind of felt like I was going off a tangent right here. And I said, really, Lord? And he said, really? Just go with it. It'll be clear to you in just a minute. Hallelujah. Somebody read 1 John 1:9 for me, please. Hallelujah.
If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins.
Yes.
And to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
It says he is faithful and just to forgive our sins. So if you have sinned, just go to him and ask him to forgive him. The Bible says he'll do it. Hallelujah. And not only will he do it, but he'll cleanse you from all unrighteousness. That means you don't even have to do that again. You don't even have to go there again. Hallelujah. He'll do it. But you know what? The number three reason, or number four, I guess I am, that people kind of miss it, is because they don't want to just take it in. They read that word and they don't want to apply it to themselves. The devil's got them all messed up telling them, I'm not worthy. My sin was too bad. God can't forgive me. Hallelujah. It's too hard. Hallelujah. But I can't even understand how somebody can forgive me for what I've done. But God says that he would forgive it. And he says that not only will I forgive you, I won't even remember it anymore. He says, as far as the east is from the west,